Now, Survivor. And Simon has been a bold player in the game of Australian Survivor and even had two immunity idols in his pocket. But ultimately, revealing this fact to those closest to him led to a jaw-dropping blindside.
I found myself as a leader and the alpha male within this tribe.
Yes.
It's a pretty good spot to be in. I am feeling pretty untouchable.
Oh, what, you guys in a secret? I have two idols.
Interesting, hey?
Oh my God. Simon just made a huge mistake. Having one idol was, you know, yeah, that's okay, that's normal, we can deal with that. Having two idols? He is now the biggest threat in the game. He's got too much power with him, and if he does make it to merge, he's got everything he needs to win this competition.
Say it, mate. Simon, the tribe has spoken.
Simon joins us now live from Brisbane. Mate, it's good to see you. Gee, you've got more front than David Jones. We loved watching you. You were untouchable. What happened?
Yeah, well, I thought I was. Oh, look, you know, it was just a perfectly executed blindside and I literally had no idea it was coming. So, yeah, full kudos to the entire tribe because they played that so well.
You have two idols that you're still wearing. Why didn't you play them?
Oh, look, I know. These things are going to haunt me for the rest of my life, aren't they? You have to have some blind faith and just some trust in the people around you. And I was just hoping that the relationships that I'd built and the conversations that I had were real. And I just had this, you know, the gut feeling that I might have been okay. And that my loyalty was my biggest downfall.
That's why it'd be cut so much, huh? Danny and the tribe, they threw the immunity challenge. Did you have any idea that's what they were doing?
Look, believe it or not, like, Danny and I were actually talking about potentially throwing that challenge to get rid of Flick because we needed to get rid of her before we went back to merge because she would have run back to Gerald and the other side. So watching them actually throw it, I was seeing what was going on, but I didn't realise that I was going to be the collateral damage from that move. And, that was really hard.
You might have been a bit too trusting, but I tell you what, you are a tough competitor. You absolutely smashed the challenges. In fact, you're a former bodybuilder. So how did that prepare you in the lead-up to Survivor?
I'd like to think I'm still a bodybuilder, but thank you very much.
Sorry, my apologies.
I think, like, look, you get a lot from, like, the resilience that comes from, you know, the dedication to your training and everything like that. But in terms of preparing for the challenges and everything, I actually spent a hell of a lot less time in the gym. I spent more time, you know, doing puzzles and, you know, doing, like, you know, always little brain teasers and things like that. You know, swimming and working on my agility and my flexibility and getting up and down off the ground and kind of rounding out my skill set, because out there, it's not a push-up competition or a deadlift comp. You know, you have to be a well-rounded competitor. Mm. And look, I really think I brought a lot to that tribe in terms of being a challenge beast. So I'm so happy to leave that mark on the game.
Oh, and look, you might not have won Survivor, but congratulations are in order. Massive congratulations. You and your fiance are engaged.
Yeah, it's super exciting for us. Aww. And, you know, really looking forward to what that means for us in the future.
How did you propose? Give us the goss.
I had a beautiful sunset picnic planned when we for a trip over in Margaret River when we went earlier this year. And as we were flying to Perth, the border shut whilst we were in the air, which was heartbreaking. So we landed, ended up in hotel quarantine, managed to get a flight home the next day. And to make that trip memorable, I decided to drop the knee at the taxi rank at the Perth domestic airport. Aww. And the rest was history.
Well, hopefully Aww. Your fiance will honour the idol situation. You got two outs, third strike and you're gone. Lots of people are playing an awesome game, but who would you like to see be crowned sole survivor?
Yeah, I tell you what, we've been done the chaos monsters this year. It's crazy watching it all go down. Look, I'd love to see a Brawn win it. I'd love to see a Challenge Beast win it. But I've got a real soft spot for Wei. But I think Danny, she either needs to go the distance and her getting rid of me was the right decision, or I want to see her fail on Sunday night and go next.
Good on you.
Australian Survivor Brains versus Brawn continues Sunday night at 7:30 on 10 and 10 Play on Demand. Simon, you are an absolute cracker.
Yeah,
maybe
thanks,
a Survivor-themed wedding is on the cards.
No, there will be no such such talk of the S word at the wedding.
All right.
That's it, yeah.
Fair enough. Hey, you were great to watch. Congratulations on an epic game. Appreciate your time, Simon.
Thank you very much, guys. And if anyone wants an idol, find them on eBay.
There we go.
What's the bidding start at, Simon?
$250,000 or two for half a mil.
Hey, that is good strategy. Good on you, mate.
Thank you again. See ya.